So all together, we say to one another and to our God, I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned in my own fault, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. And I ask Blessed Mary and Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
God of power and mercy, we ask you to send your Holy Spirit to live in our hearts and to make us temples of God's glory. We make our prayers through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us be seated as the readings are declared for us.
Liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor. and a day of vindication by our God, to comfort all who mourn, to place on those who mourn in Zion a diadem instead of ashes, to give them oil of gladness in place of mourning, a glorious mantle instead of a listless spirit. You yourselves shall be named priests of the Lord, ministers of our God you shall be called. I will give them their recompense faithfully. A lasting covenant I will make with them. Their descendants shall be renowned among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge them as a race the Lord has blessed. This is the word of the Lord.
The reason that the world hates you
Remember what I told you, that no slave is greater than his master. They will harry you as they harried me. They will respect your words as much as they respected mine. All this they will do to you because of my name, for they know nothing of him who sent me. When the Paraclete comes, the Spirit of truth who comes from the Father, and whom I myself will send from the Father, he will bear witness on my behalf. You must bear witness as well, for you have been with me from the beginning. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Let us be seated. Graduates of Sacred Heart Catholic School, you will probably find yourselves over the years talking to people who sell drugs and who sell themselves. You will find that you have chatted with someone who steals cars or steals life from her or children. You will speak to neighbors who see no beauty in life, who are despairing, and who feel terribly lonely because they have no God other than their graves, themselves, or some other human person who is amongst them.
What a welcome, powerfulness.
This is not what Paul is supposed to talk about on our graduation night. But those are some of the things that you will see in God. And I say to you, these are depressing, difficult things. And the reason I mention them is to show you how far away from yourself these things are. I show the downside of life so that you may realize how gifted you are in the upside of life. You carry within yourselves a tremendous gift, a gift that has been given to you by your parents, by your teachers, and by yourselves. You have given yourself the gift of knowing how to live in God's light. And that gift of knowing how to live in God's light is a gift that is beginning and has begun and that will move through all the rest of your life. If you look at your stomach, probably you don't see a big scar down the middle. But inside of your stomach and your intestines, as far as I'm concerned, there's a great big bar of gold. It's in there, but you don't see it. And if you look in your heart, there's a beautiful diamond. Maybe it's not polished up yet, but it's there. It's there. And you have begun. This treasure has been placed there by your parents, your teachers, and by yourself. And what you do with that bar of gold inside, and what you do with that diamond in your heart, is going to be up to you for the next years of your life. The scripture that we heard today in the first reading says, "The Spirit of the Lord God, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the lonely, to heal the brokenhearted, to announce a year of favor to the Lord." All of those individuals that you find who are living kind of a broken life, who are are empty, who are desolate, who have empty bank accounts in the spiritual world. You're full. You're full. And you don't realize this yet, but you have a gift of knowing who you are. You have a gift of beauty, a gift of joy, a gift of spirit in your God. And so you are then being prepared to announce to the world that the world is good, that life is good. What a gift you have. You know, that gift grows kind of slowly. The diamond is polished up rather slowly. You get to spin the bar of gold slowly. It's like whenever I go over to the school and I look at your science fair projects, and I see the egg that goes through the 21 days of hatching. You know, you wait for it and it grows. You're only at 12 years of hatching, huh? You've got a number of years more to hatch up, as it were. All right, the one that I really enjoy the most is the one where you pour the sole and the coloring. I can't think of what kind of the bluing together in there. And the crystals begin to grow, and they make beautiful, multicolored crystals. It's a slow life that you have. But it's there now. And I guess that's what I want to impress upon you. You know, Father Becker is up there moving around, and he's saying, there's something inside of me that I feel inside of me special. And I say, it's there. It's there. And the older you get, the more you know it's there. It's slowly. And it's a gift that you give to the world. Jesus was in the temple when he was 12 years old. And the scripture says that Jesus was lost. He was lost in a foreign temple, in a foreign city. Maybe you're going to feel lost in a foreign school. But Jesus was so much aware of that gold in his stomach, of the diamond in his heart. Jesus said, God is my Father, and I must be about my Father's business. And so the more that you know that God is the gold and the diamonds within you, then whether you're in a foreign school, whether you're in a foreign city, whether you're walking with foreign people, whoever that may be, you will have that same sense that Jesus Christ had at the age of 12, when he was able to say, oh, I'm not lost, Father, Dad. You're the one that's lost. I know where I am. I'm God's son. I must be about my Father's business. God is my Father. I know who I am. Source of your strength. There is one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. One God and Father of all, who is over all, works through all, and is in all. You have, as it were, come to a point wherein you have received wisdom of individuals who are 30, 60 years of age. People come to me sometimes in counseling, and they'll say, you know, Father, I think I'm going to put God first in my life. I know what my problem is now. And it takes them 30 years, 40 years, or 60 years to come to that point. And you have been brought to that point early, as a gift. You're so much ahead of those individuals who are 30 years old, who are out there, and they don't know where they're going. They don't know that there is God here. They don't know how to live, but you do. Basically, you're special. Some people are running after the Olympian goal or the goal that they get in business. But I hope that your goal, that you go after first, is God's goal. Some people are going to find themselves laying on the floor filled with spirits. But I hope that the spirits that you go after is the gift of God. heal. God, I'm here. I'm 12 years old. I'm 13. I'm 11. I believe you said you are. And I'm going to go out quote-unquote into that great big world. But you're not going to go out alone. You are going to have your parents. You are going to have your sons. And I think really the most important thing is that you will know us and that you will have the Lord God with you all the days of your life. Let us stand for just an opportunity to stand. Receive these gifts from the people of God. To become the gifts which God gives to his people. Thank you. pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
And the Lord accept sacrifice at his hands, for praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his church.
Amen. O Lord our God, we celebrate the memorial of our redemption by which your Son won for us the gift of the Holy Spirit to be with us for all time. Accept our evening offering on this happy day and send us your Holy Spirit to make us more like Christ in bearing witness to the world, to be Christ in the world. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord. At this time, unannounced, I would like to ask the graduates to please join me around the altar of the Lord as it were for the last time in this setting. Please come forward. The Lord Jesus, on the night before he died, said, "I wish to be with you, my friends." Come on, please. Just the graduates. So y'all won't have to come up with me in the world on Wednesdays and Fridays. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, all powerful and ever living God, we dwell always and everywhere to give you thanks. Father, you renew the church in every age by raising up men and women outstanding in holiness, living witnesses of your unchanging love. These men and women inspire us by their heroic lives and help us by their constant prayers so that we may be the living sign of your saving power in our day. We praise you, Lord, with all the angels and the saints in their song of joy as we say, supper was ended, Jesus took the cup, gave you thanks and praise, gave it up to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven." So in song we proclaim the mystery of our faith.
Mm-hmm.
invite you to remain as you are as the students present their litany of thanksgiving.
Please respond and thank you, O Lord.
Thank you, O Lord.
For the gift of love.
We thank you, O Lord.
For our teachers, parents, and religious leaders for giving us a strong religious education.
We thank you, O Lord.
For our families and friends for supporting us through our elementary school years.
We thank you, O Lord.
For our parents for sending us to a high academic school.
We thank you, O Lord.
That we were not harmed to the natural disaster.
We thank you, O Lord.
For our individual gifts from God.
We thank you, O Lord.
For those who have applied to high academic fields and succeeded.
We thank you, O Lord.
For Jesus who has saved us from our sins.
We thank you, O Lord.
For the gifts of the Holy Spirit.
We thank you, O Lord.
For everybody who participates in the graduation ceremony.
We thank you, O Lord.
O God, our Father, we gather this evening to thank you for the gift of life and to thank you for the gift of eternal life that comes to us through Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit. Father, make us always grateful. Make us always thankful. And let our hearts always be filled with that deep joy, because we know that we are destined for eternal life with a loving God. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord. Our closing communion prayer. Lord, help those whom you have anointed by your Holy Spirit and nourished by this ceremony. Support us through every trial, and by our works of love, build up your body here on earth in holiness and in joy. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Let us be seated. Sister Mary Jane, the principal of our school, come forward.
Thank you.
special because they are your children. And all of you at this time also know that these graduates are special to this community of Sacred Heart because this is the 25th graduating class of Sacred Heart School. So I want you graduates to remember that not only did you graduate tonight, but from this School of Sacred Heart, you are the 25th graduating class. We are celebrating our 25th anniversary as a school tonight, and we want you to come back in 25 years, and then you'll all be like 35 or whatever, we'll be celebrating then our 50th year of Sacred Heart School. So I invite you to receive the 25th graduating
Dad said, where did all the graduates go?
Say, man, congratulations.
Another. You're kind of able to be with one another in the neighborhood that you live. kept careful watch over the school for 25 years. Jesus has kept careful watch over Sacred Heart School. And we're now asking the Lord to keep careful watch for another 25 years over Sacred Heart School. But also, and more importantly, we want the Lord Jesus Christ to keep careful watch over each of you for the next 25 years at least. It is my prayer that you will stay close to the Sacred Heart of Jesus for 25 years. And whenever you think of maybe living a different kind of lifestyle or breaking away from God, I hope that maybe you'll think somewhere on that property at Sacred Heart School where I went to school, there's this time capsule buried. And it's kind of like an idea that God is sending out his grace and strength and saying, I love you, stay faithful. Jesus is keeping careful watch over us. The idea for 25 years to persevere, to stay with it, to let the Lord God live in our hearts. We come together this afternoon then to ask the Lord to bless this time capsule, to bless the success of Sacred Heart School, that it may continue at least another 25 years, giving the traditions of Jesus Christ to children who are to come through these doors. But more importantly, we ask the Lord Jesus to bless each of us for the next 25 years of our lives. Let us stand. O Lord our God, we have chosen those symbols, those objects, which we have placed in this time capsule. We ask you to bless this time capsule in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Keep us faithful to your holy word, O Lord. Send your protection, your angels, to guard not only this time capsule, but also to guard us, to keep us fresh and new, to keep us living and alive in Christ. We ask for your protection over Sacred Heart School, for all of its teachers, its principal, its staff, for all of the priests who will minister here in the future. And we make our prayers through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please remain standing.
Put that over your head and let us clap as Bradley puts it down into the grave for the next 25 years.
Capsule, the temperature has dipped to the low 20s with a chill factor around 10, they suggest, although the sun's shining brightly. It's March 3rd, 1989, the sixth grade of Sacred Heart School.
Oh!
You are a team. You will work as a team. Team five. First thing we need to do, listen carefully, some qualifications a spokesperson needs. Be able to speak loudly and clearly, and be able to answer without a lot. Each group needs a spokesperson. Take a vote on it. Don't pick yourself. Become this field studying human rights. We will go in order, team one, team two,
Drop it in the bucket.
Get something to wet your whistle, and the whistle is dry, you know. But there it goes. Congratulations, sister, on the recipient of the Community Service Award. She has done so much for our community, not only our parish community, but citywide. And we appreciate all of that you've done. You've done a fantastic job. Look for many more years for it. Now, station of the quarterly check to sister that we agreed when we started the bingo here at Sacred Heart to contribute 60% of the net proceeds of our bingo toward the upkeep of the school. And we've held true to that, and normally the other, in case you're not familiar with the bingo laws, you know, we're required to give 100% of our proceeds to charity. 60% automatically goes to Sacred Heart. And the rest of it, most of it, winds up back here at Sacred Heart, too, so we're glad to do it.
I got one, give it two.
Jason, is that fun?